Apex class, how to take data from the VF page with the help of the data, how to create a record. Right. Now, while I am inserting the data, there is a possibility that record may be successfully inserted or record may fail while I am trying to insert. I cannot guarantee that always the record will be successful. There is a possibility that record may fail. There is a possibility that record may fail. In case if the record fails, how do you handle it? In case if the record fails, how do you handle it? Right. Now here we had a quick point here. Exception handling. What is this exception handling? We had a concept of exception handling. What was the concept of exception handling? Was if I take statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, what is the order of execution? When I execute, 1, 2, 3 will be executed. Suppose when I have statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, error at line number 3, at line number 2. If this error at line number 2, what will happen? 1 and fit. If I give error at line number 1, it's a error. Okay, at line number 1, print the line number 1 fit. That means terminate the program. Abnormal termination of the program. Abnormal termination of the program. Now, it is an error. When I get an error, what is happening? Program is getting quitted. Program is not continuing. So, look at this here. I have some statements. This is how I was trying to, right. I have account ACC equal to new account ACC dot name. Now we have written a program like this. So what is the order of execution? 1, 2, 3, okay, insert the, okay, apply the 4, 5, 6, 7, then 8, 9, 10. Sequential order it is going to get. Now execute. When execute, what is the output we are going to get? You will get executable. What is the order? 1, 2, 3, it is taking ready lab, phone number, insert, account, then what happened? Line number 4, line number 5, line number 6. Now, what is the order of execution? One by one line, we are getting executed. If you look at the debug, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We are getting 6 records. Right? So, everything is getting executed. Suppose, if there is any error here, what is that name? Name is a required field. When the name is a required field, it is a must that I have to provide record name. Name is a required field, it is a must that I have to provide a record name. If I don't provide a record name, it throws an error message. Name is required. Now in the account, name is required. In case if the required data is not provided, In case if the required data is not provided, we are going to get an error message. So go to execute. When execute, what happened here? Required field missing. The entire program is terminated. Why? 1, 2, 3. I am trying to insert an account. Account insertion failed, so the DML operation failed. Account insertion failed, so the DML operation failed. Account insertion failed, so the DML operation failed. Right. So what happened? Remaining statements are executed? No. It is quitting the program. It is quitting the program. What is the output we are going to get here? What is the output we are going to get? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There is a problem with this. So stop the program, come out. Stop the program and come out. So are these lines are executed? Now, what I want to do, boss, in case if there is any problem, you are telling this is having a problem. In case if you have a problem, you want to give the solution also. Now, if there is any problem, it is stopping the program coming out. But your requirement is, in case if you have any problem, don't quit the program. Don't stop the program. Okay. Now, if there is any problem, do this. If there is any problem, do this. So, I want to give alternate solution to your problem. I want to give alternate solution to your problem. Are you getting my point here? In case if you are getting any issue, how do you resolve it? Now, in such type of cases, right, then we have a concept called exception handling. So, what is the concept of exception handling? Now, what is an exception? What is an error? What is an exception handling? Now, look at the point. Let me give you a quick story. Now, let us say, general example what I give. Today is my wife's birthday. Okay, I forgot to wish in the morning. I came back to the institute. As usual, I came to institute. Now, my regular schedule is, I'll go, okay, by 7 I have to come to institute, take the class. At around 8:30, my driver will bring some breakfast for me. Okay, I'll have my breakfast. Continue with the, okay, next class. Right, then I need to go to my office. My driver will bring some lunch for me. Eat. This is the sequence. Now, in the morning, I forgot to wish her for birthday. Then what happened? At 8:40, I didn't receive my breakfast. Then I felt something wrong. Opened my mobile phone. Then I found somebody is wishing, okay, group of relatives wishing the birthday. There's some groups are there, right? WhatsApp group. Contact will be only 2, but groups will be 100. Right. So there are 100 groups, people posting the messages. If you try to come out of the group, that's all, immediately relations will cut down. So the people started sending the message. Now I saw the message. Now I found that there is a mistake happened. Now if I don't rectify it, my lunch also will not come. Right. Now look at that. There's a sequence of steps. In the sequence of steps, I forgot to wish my wife. Then what happened? In the coming statement, there's a problem. I didn't receive my breakfast. If I don't wish, okay, if I don't rectify it, lunch also will be stopped. If I don't rectify my lunch, liar will come. Right. So, immediately I call my office boy. I told him, boss, can you purchase some bouquet, send it to my house, say that it's a surprise gift. If she was convinced that I remembered and I sent a surprise, now everything goes well. Otherwise, termination. So what was that? Then when there is a possibility of an error, what is the attempt that you are making to rectify it? When there is a possibility of an error, what is the attempt you are trying to rectify it? If you don't make any attempt, it will terminate the program. If you try to make an attempt to resolve it, it may be rectified, may not be rectified. Now I sent a gift. Okay, if she was convinced that I remembered, then what happened? Rest of the program will go normally. So from 9 o'clock, schedule run as usual. If she was not convinced, what happened? So if she was not convinced, a lawyer will visit my house. So the termination of the program will come here. Now this is what I am trying to make an attempt. Now when I made an attempt, look at the point, try to get the concept here. I'm just trying to make it generalized. Then she told, let's go for a shopping. Okay, I thought she may take purchase some clothes. I told, let's go, no problem. When I went to the shop, she told Inorbit Mall, I thought maybe purchasing some dresses. But when I went to Inorbit Mall, she has taken me to some ornament shop. Now, if I know very well that she is going to take to ornament shop, okay, I will cancel shopping, I will come to class. Right. But I don't know till I go to Inorbit Mall, I don't know that it's going to be ornament shopping. I felt it was a... So if the problem is known to you well in advance, you will not get into it. Am I right? It's called compile time errors. It's called compile time errors. Before you start, if you know what is the problem you are going to get, now we give an alternate solution for it, escape from it. Now, this is what? Compile time error. But I didn't know that she was taken into ornament shop till I get into the shopping mall. Right, that I cannot avoid that. It is a runtime error. What when? It is a runtime error. After I got in there, then I got an issue. So this is a runtime error. Now, errors are going to be a runtime errors. When it is a runtime error, if you are able to handle or not is the question. Runtime errors, unable to handle, there is an error. Runtime issues, it is a quit. Runtime errors, unable to handle, abnormal termination. Right. Then we went to the shop. She was trying to purchase an ornament of 5 or 6 lakhs. But I cannot say that my package is only 3 lakhs per annum. I cannot say it. So I called the sales guy and told, I will give 50,000 rupees to you. Whatever my wife purchased, tell that it is sold. It is already sold. The stock is not available. If the sales guy was convinced with my offer. Now, if the sales guy was convinced with my offer, if he takes 50,000 for me and say, whatever my wife select, say that already sold, stock will be coming in the next month. Then, issue is resolved. If the guy was not convinced, he told to my wife, husband is offering this amount for telling this. Then what happened? It is again what? I made my attempt to resolve it, but my attempt failed. So, every attempt you try to make may not be success. Okay? If it is not success, again it will be what? Error. I offered him 50,000 rupees to do this, but he conveyed to my wife the same offer what I gave. That is what? My attempt failed. Again, the abnormal termination of the program. And he was convinced to take that 50,000 rupees and he was doing what I want to. Then what is that? Then the program goes in the normal way. Now, the story, first point. If you know that some problem you are going to get well in advance, what will you do? You will handle it in the compile time. Okay, if you know 100% this problem will occur, I will handle it in the compile time. Now, there is a possibility that this type of problem may occur, then the exception handling will come. If there is a possibility that exception may occur, this type of problem may occur, then go for what? Exception. Possibility. It may or may not occur. I cannot give 100% possibility. Okay, 100% I cannot say this. Let me take another example. I want to go for a movie. When I'm planning to go for a movie, now I'm expecting there may be a possibility of traffic. I'm expecting there may be a possibility of traffic. Now, if 100% traffic will be there, I will start 1 hour before. But it's not always, there's a possibility that there may be a traffic. Then I encountered a traffic, then I had a plan B how to reach. Because I was expecting some, I also prepared for this type of problem. Now I am expecting that there may be a possibility of traffic on the route what I have chosen. If there is a traffic in this road, I already have planned how to reach. Because there is a possibility of traffic, I have already know there is a possibility of traffic. So I taken my steps to reach the theater with a plan A and plan B. Now always I expect 100% there is a traffic. Then I'll have permanent solution. It is not a possibility. 100% traffic will be there. I will take well in advance the precautionary steps to reach to that location. Am I right or wrong? So this is what? Compile time. Before you, when you are writing a program, you know 100% this type of problem may be coming. Then I will not put that statement in the program. I will try to give workaround procedure. But there is a possibility that the problem may occur, may not occur. 50-50 chances are there. 50-50 chances are there. It may occur, may not occur. then I should be prepared to handle it in case if they occur. They are not always they occur. There is a 50% chance that they may occur. When there is a 50% chance that they may occur, I will prepare for both the possibilities. If the problem occur, how to run? Doesn't occur, how to run? That's what. I hope you got my point. So this is what the possibility will come in the runtime. There is a possibility of encountering a problem that will come when I am executing the program, not before. Before executing the program, if I know this type of problem is coming, I will give a permanent fix. So your errors or exceptions will be occurred during runtime only. Your errors, exception will occur at a runtime only. Okay, compile time, whatever the problems are coming, all of them are syntactical errors. Right. Now when you go to runtime, you may get exceptions or errors. Now if error occurred, you are not expecting a problem, but the problem occurred, then what? That will terminate the program. Now you are already expecting this type of problem, you have given a fix to it, then what happened? You are given exception. Are you following these points here? Right. Look at this. Am I expecting any problem here? I am not expecting any problem. So I have not given a fix. So when I am executing these lines, you got a problem. Now if I am expecting a problem, I am given a permanent fix. Right. Then what is the solution you have? Then I give try. What is this try? Any statement which may raise an error, any statements, Rashmi, meet your mic, come on. Any statement which may raise an error, they are defined within a try. Now, if you feel that these statements may raise a problem, that we are going to put in try. When you put in try, if the problem occurs, what it will do? It will not terminate the program. It will simply go to catch, run the catch. What is a catch? The solution to problem what occurred. If this type of problem occurred, then what should I do is define catch. So what is given in the try? The statements which may raise a problem, which may raise an error, they are defined in a try. The statements which may raise an issue or an error, they are defined within a try. In case if the statements in the try, causes any error, how to handle that, what should I do is defined in catch. I hope you got my point. So go to the execute. You know there are two connections on your name. Get one connection removed. So what I am giving here, line 1, line 2, line 3, then what happened? Insert, fail, line 4, line 5, line 6. Now look at this, what did I give? Actually what should be the output? 1, 2, 3, insertion, success. But this is not printing. When the problem occurred here, immediately it came to catch. In the catch, what they are giving? Type of problem what you are encountering, then we are going for 4, 5, 6. I hope you got my point. When the problem occur, go to the catch, execute. go to the catch, execute. Go to the catch, execute. Right. I hope you are good with this. Yeah. You know there are two connections on your name. Remove one connection. Right.
That is attending development classes. I'm from 317.
Right. No issue. The other Vinod.
Satish.
Yeah.
I'm from 319 batch.
Right. Could you please put your initial so that I can recognize it?
Okay, Satish.
Right. So when you have this story, come back here. So I can make it the statement here. I hope you are clear with this one. Statement one. Try. Statement four. Statement. This is the program. When I read the program, first, no error. When there is no error, what is the output? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11, 12, 13. Why did you put them in try? I am expecting there is a possibility of getting an error. I felt line number 4, 5, 6, they may raise a problem. There is a possibility that they may raise a problem, so I kept them in a try. Now, what is the catch? In case the problem occurs in this try, what should I do is defined in catch. There is no problem. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now, error at line number 2. Are you expecting any error at line number 2? You are not expecting. So what will happen? Did you have any mechanism to handle it? No, I don't have any mechanism. So what will happen? One, quit the program. I am encoding error at line number 5. Are you expecting a error at line number 5? Then catch was unable to handle this. Then what is it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Problem occurred at 5, so immediately jump to catch. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now, error occurred at line number 5, but catch unable to what happened? 1, 2, 3, 4. Catch was not able to solve the problem. I gave a solution. This is not a right fix. What happened? Program will terminate. I hope you are good. So try, catch. Try, catch. What are you going to put in try? What are you trying to put in try? Any statements which may raise an issue, we are going to put those statements in the try. What are you going to give in catch? In case if any error occurred in the try, how to handle it is defined in a catch. Try, catch. I hope everyone is good with this. Right? I hope everyone is good with this. So if there is any possibility of an error, we are going to put those statements in try. If the error occurs, what should I do? Define in catch. So what is this mechanism called? Exception handling. Exception handling, a simplified concept. I hope everyone is good with this. Right? If any possibility of error occurs, if you know that there is a possibility of occurrence of an error, put them in try. If you know that there is a possibility, permission. There is a possibility. Now, there is a, if you feel that there is a possibility of occurrence of an error, we put them in try. If the error occurs, what should I do is define in catch. Is that all clear? Now, why did you get into this topic now? Why did you get into this topic? Yesterday, we was trying to create some messages. What was that? Success message and error message. I was trying to insert the data. Yesterday, I was trying to insert the data. I will try to use the same program. Duplicate value found. Now, I was taking it public thing. Then I was trying to give public void create. Now somebody asked me in the beginning, why you are not taking constructor? Now I don't want to initialize anything. If I want to set any values, initial values, I'll take constructor. Now I don't want to set any initial values. Straight away I want to go for logic. Now what I'm trying to do, try account ACC equal to user dot name equal to ACC, data dot rating equal to data dot phone equal to, this is how empty. Then I was trying to give insert system dot debug insertion success. Now if it is success, I'm giving a message. Still I not cover this point, I'm just showing the output. Once this is done, I'll show it. Message equal to this message apex page dot severity. Confirm. Record inserted. Now in case if the DML operation failed, then I'm giving here. Then I'm giving here what? Catch. This exception will give you the type of problem what occurred. Then I'm giving, in case if the DML failed, I was giving I want to give what is the message? E.get. So I gave you this. Now what was that? Boss, if the DML, if the insertion was successful, then print the message called success. If the insertion failed, tell the reason why it failed. If the insertion failed, tell the reason why the insertion failed. So go back to the page. I'm just trying to copy paste the example, Amma. Whatever you've done. I hope people are comfortable with the page block section item, right? Just to avoid the time I was giving here. Simply few mail changes I am going to make it. Example 6, it was ACC name, ACC industry. I have taken name, rating, phone, and ins. Right, I gave data dot. It is a variable. I can give ACC industry or ABC or it's my choice. Right, Amma? Now, what I have given here? Now, let us run the program. Have a preview. This is the data what I am getting. Energy. Error. Record fields missing. Account name. Value is. Right. So, if the record failed, I want to get it. Now, the DML is not successful. DML is not successful. If it is successful, record was saved successful. Now, there are two possibilities. I was making an attempt to make a DML operation. The DML may be success, may be fail. If it is success, no problem. If it is failed, I don't want system to generate some message. Now, DML exception. Now, I want to print my own message saying that boss, this is failed because of this reason. Are you getting my point? I don't want the system generated message. When you go to ATM, withdraw the money, if they give automatic exception, then what the customer will do? He'll break the ATM and go. He has to understand what the error is. Line number 102, okay, S capital is missing. I cannot give the step of error in the ATM. I have to generate the error, what you understand, insufficient fields, okay, funds, invalid password. I have to generate this. When I generate what the customer understands, it will be understandable to the customer, end user, where what went wrong. He can rectify it. So, it should be user generated messages. Now, why did I get into try catch now? When you are making a DML operation, it is always a good practice to put DML operations in try catch. Why? Because in case there is a possibility, 100% possibility that there may be an error. There is a possibility that my operation may or may not be successful. It may be because of validation rule. It may be because of duplicate data. It may be because of any one of the automated operations what we have. It is because record fields are not entered. It is because of the ranges of the data what I give. Name I give length 10 characters, but you are entering 20 characters. There will be error here. Are you getting my point? To resolve the DML operations, we will always try to put the statements in try catch. Now, what is this try catch? Exception handling mechanism. What is an exception? Error which occurred at runtime handled is an exception. Okay, the runtime error which occurred not handled, it is what? Error. Are you getting my point? Error will quit the program, exception will jump the statement. When it's an exception, it will jump the statement, go to the next line. I hope you are good. It will jump the execution from try to catch, run the program. Error, it will quit the program. Exception in the try, it will jump from try to catch, continue the program. Right? What is this mechanism called? Exception handling mechanism. What is this mechanism called? Exception handling mechanism. It is always good practice. It is always good practice to put DML operations within the try catch. If you don't put in a try catch, nobody is going to beat you. Right? But it's a good practice to define DML within a try catch. There are some good thumb rules of writing a program. One such step of thumb rule is, okay, putting the DML operations within a try catch. Okay, if the insertion failed, we also want to know what happened, what went wrong. I hope you're good with this. Clear for everyone?
Right.
Now, right. So here, come back to the next story. I will also explain this. We'll do an example later. Okay. Now, what was this apex pages dot message? Now, what is this apex pages dot message? Look at the point. Look at this. Here, public. Now, somebody asked me constructor. Now, look at this. Now, I have a requirement. When the page is loaded, automatically this should be printed. Now, when the create button is called, in the previous example, when did the create action performed? When I clicked on the button, it called a create, it inserted the data. So, I want the action to be performed when I click on a button. But here I am saying, I will not click on a button, automatically when the page loads, some data should be displayed. The previous example is what? Enter the data, click on create, the data will be inserted. But here what I am saying, I don't want to click on any button. The moment the page is loaded, automatically data should be displayed. So I was giving here apex pages. What is this apex pages? It is a predefined namespace. Apex pages is a predefined namespace. In that predefined namespace, what is message? It is a apex class. Predefined apex class. Salesforce defined apex class. Message is Salesforce defined apex class. Using this class, what I can create? Page messages I can create. Messages on the VF page. Now, I was giving message equal to new apex page dot. While you are creating a message, what type of message? Success message, error message, warning message, information. Now here we are giving apex page dot. We're giving apex page dot severity. Confirm. Success message. Once I created this message, where this message should be added? Apex page dot. Whatever the current page you are referring, add this message to the current page. Now create a message, add it to the current page. So what I was doing, apex page dot. Error. So what we do? Apex page dot. Then again, I'm giving same story. Apex page dot. Severity, warning, message, apex page is dot add message. Now what I am doing? Created a messages and added the messages to the page. Any spell mistake anywhere?
Near message to, add message to, miss the semicolon.
Okay. Now, so we have created a messages, added the messages to the page. Now, automatically these messages are added when the page is loaded. In the constructor I am doing, right? So, add the page messages. When you click on preview, what are you getting here? Error message, warning message, information, success. Right? This is just because of the type of message. Severity, confirm, error, info, warning. Are you getting my point here? So basically, look at the story here. It is a predefined Apex class.
Satish.
This is defined. One minute, Amma. This is defined under the namespace of Apex pages. This is used to generate messages. And add to the syntax. What is the syntax that we have? Apex page dot message. Apex page dot type of severity. Type can be confirm, error, warning, once a message is created, add the message to front page, user. If you want display those messages on the VF page, then use add Apex page messages. Right, Amma? I hope you got the story. Yes, online, go ahead. Look at the code. Anyone has any query, let me know. Online, go ahead with your question.
Satish, when execute this, the order of messages are changed. Success message you are given, but it is coming last. Why?
Maybe alphabetical. The order is only listed. What was this? This is information, this error. Look at the alphabetical format. Maybe because of alphabetical format here. E, W, this. Maybe the order may be sequenced in this format. Error, warning, info, success. Let me find out, Amma. So, I don't guess like basically confirm, error, warning, info. It's not even alphabetical order. Maybe the order may be fixed in this format. Okay. Let me know the reason. Okay. I never thought of this. Okay. Right. Let me go to the next point. I'll inform you in the next session. Right. Okay. I never thought of this. The reason why it is in the sequence order. Okay. Now, come back to the story. I hope everyone is good with this. This guy has a question. Why this order is changed? The order we inserted is confirm error warning info. But why you are getting error warning info success? Okay. Maybe they might have, okay, given the order while displaying the message, in case of group of messages, they might have defined what is the format of this. Right. Probably you can convey in this way. Because of the error, in case of any error, then what are the corresponding warnings, then other information, if it is the final set, they are given the least priority for the success. Yes, Amma?
So, yeah, I think validation comes first in the order of execution.
That may be the reason.
That could be the reason.
The basic reason may be, when you are printing it, if there are any errors in the page, so first show the errors and the corresponding warnings in the pages, then give the other related information. Probably that may be the reason why they are showing it in this order. Okay. But let me give a correct reason. In case if there is any specific reason, let me find out and give you.
Satish, it may be because of severity order.
That's what I'm saying. Now,
yeah.
This may be because of the enum type. Instead of predicting it, I'll just okay, cross check and give you. Okay. Let me cross check and give you if there is any specific reason for it. Okay. One possibility is, as somebody told, the severity order, it's an enum. So in whatever the order we have defined in the enum, probably that may be the reason. That may be the probable reason for it. That may be the probable reason. Okay, somebody has already Googled it. Right. So let me go back to this. You know, what you're getting? Confirm, error, throttle, info, warning. So, here we have, it is not enum order also. If it is enum order, then we are supposed to get confirm first. Now, this is alphabetical order he has given. See, here the display was given to you in the form of alphabetical order because there is a documentation. Now, what internally it is stored, let me check it out. Okay. So let me give you, in case if you want to define the order, there's a possibility. So let me not get into unwanted discussion now. Okay. Now I'll cross check that. In case if any reason is there, I'll cross check and let you know. But out of all these batches, none of the people has asked the question. Right. Chalo, come back to the story. Now we are given the page message. So we are giving the page message. This is to generate the messages. Now try catch and page messages. Now we are trying to use the try catch and page messages. Now this is to generate a success message or error message. Now both the topics are clear for everyone. Right. Now let me do the example, the combination once again. Then I'll give one more extension for you. Look at the point. Now, public string industry public string last name . So I took the data like this. Now I was trying to create a public void. Then I was giving apex page dot message. Try catch. What I was trying to do, account ACC equal to ACC dot name equal to ACC dot phone equal to So whatever the data I was taking from the VF page, I was giving. Insert account. After inserting the account, I am trying to create contact also. Create a contact, contact dot last name. Trying to insert the contact. Then this contact dot contact is a child of contact is a child of account. What is the lookup field name? Account. Contact is a child of account. In the lookup field, what will be there? ID of the parent record will be there. Account ID equal to ACC dot. Whichever the account I created above, for that account I am giving this contact. Now tell me, there is a possibility that account may fail. There is a possibility that contact may fail. Okay. Now I was giving message equal to new Apex page dot. Apex page dot severity. Severity dot confirm insertion. Account and contact create. Then we're giving message create. Now catch exception. Then in the exception, what I was giving, new space dot message. I give this. Then I was giving Apex page dot add. Boss, I was trying to create an account with a contact. If it is successfully inserted, I want to give success message. If it failed, I want to give why the record failed. Did you get my point here? We are trying to create an account with a contact. Now, the choice here. In the standard controller, how many S objects we are able to refer? One. If I want to work with more than one object, I am going for Apex. I am able to work with the account and a contact. Standard controller will help you to work with only one S object. If you want to work with more than one S object, we are going for Apex class. Now, get back to the VF page. Can I copy the previous VF page? If your people have followed that, I'll copy that example. Everyone have followed the previous? I'll try to add extra content on this. Can I copy the previous? Everyone is good with that? Okay with that? Okay. Everyone has followed that? Then I was giving here. Example. Now, section. Here I am giving title equal to. Title equal to account. Collapsible equal to false. So here we had account name, industry. Rating. Now I was creating one more section. This is all about account creation. One more section. You have last name. first name. Then I had email. Then we have this we give. Have a preview. So look at this. We are giving here account, contact. Account and contact. We are giving account and contact. Now I was trying to insert here. Save it. Now what happened? Account created successfully. Now if you go back, account. Now I gave Dell, right? So Satish, I hope you are good. Account, contact. If that insertion failed, it is going to throw error message. If the insertion failed, it is going to throw error message. Is that was clear for everyone? Now the point here is. Record created. Now we are getting a success message. Record created. Success message getting. I don't want to see the success message. If the record was created, take me to that record. Show me the message only if it is an error. If the insertion failed, throw error message and show me the page. If the record was successfully inserted, take me to that record. Are you getting my point? Now how are you checking record is successfully done or not? Going to the particular object, checking the record is coming or not. I don't want to do that. If the record was successfully inserted, let me take the control to that particular record. Whichever the record you inserted, take me to that record. So what you want? You want to navigate from one page to this page to another page. You want to navigate from this page to another page. If the record was successfully inserted, take me to that particular page. When the record was successfully inserted, take me to that particular page. So what I was doing here, how to navigate from one page to another page. Now the question is, how do you navigate from one page to another page? So look at the format here. If you want to navigate from one page to another page, we have a concept called page. What was the concept called? Page reference. Page reference. When I say page reference, refer to that particular page. Refer to that particular page. So here I was giving. I was giving P equal to new page reference. How do you open a particular record, Amma? Salesforce.com/ID of the record, right? If you want to open any particular record, salesforce.com/ID of the record. So what I'm doing here? ACC. What is this ACC.ID? Once the account is inserted, we are going to get ID of the record, am I right? Once the account is inserted, we are going to get ID of the account. Whichever the ID we got, open that record. /ACCID means salesforce.com/ID of the account what you inserted, open that record. Right. Then I gave return P. Now what is this? What is the value of P? Null. What is the value of P? Null. Value of P is null. If the record was successfully inserted, then P equal to this. If record is not successfully inserted, P equal to what? Null. Are you getting my point? P is null when the record is not inserted. P is equal to salesforce.com acc.id when record is successfully created. P equal to null means go back to the same page from where you came. P equal to null means go back to the same page from where you came. Okay. Now, what I am taking here, instead of void, I was supposed to give. When you call this method, check whether the record was inserted successfully or not. If the record was successfully inserted, this is the P. If record is not inserted successfully, P equal to null. When you say return P, return null means go back to the same page. Return salesforce.com/ID means go to that particular page. Are you getting my point? Is that was clear? Return null means which page call you, go back to the page. Which page call you, when you clicked on a button, you call this method. When you clicked on a button, you call this method. When you clicked on a button, you call this method. Go back to the same page where you click the button. Okay. P equal to new page reference slash acc.id means go back to that particular record which is inserted right now. I hope you are good. So go back again. I was giving it. Getting auto-populated. Now we are getting you can give here. When I saved, what is that? Coming back to the record which is successfully inserted. I was able to come to this record. That is because I told page reference. Now, what is a page reference? It is a predefined Apex class. Page reference is a predefined Apex class which is used to refer to a particular page. Page reference is a predefined Apex class which is used to refer to a particular page by giving their URL or by giving their page name. By giving the page name or by giving the URL, I can refer to that particular page. Now you got the output, meaningful output now. Right. I already gave an ID, right? What did I give? acc.id. I gave an ID, no. Here I'm giving slash plus acc.id. I gave the ID of the record. I gave the ID of the record that is a resident is going to that particular record. Here I gave. Right. So, the topics what you learned in the last session and today, combination is this. What is the combination? Last session, from the page, we are entering the data. Okay. How to read the data in the VF page. We okay. How to read the data in the Apex class. How to read the data in the Apex class. Then, what we are giving you? Then, what I am trying to give you? Okay. When you click on create, insert the data. There is a possibility that the DML may be failure. Suppose account inserted successfully, contact failed. Then what will happen? Account will be saved, only contact will fail. Suppose account failed. If this statement failed, both account and contact failed. Why? Coming from top to bottom. If top statement is failed, bottom lines will not be executed. If bottom line is failed, only the bottom lines will not be executed. Top line will be executed. I hope you are good. Got it? Okay. Now remember, it is always a good practice to put DMLs within a try catch. DML in the try catch. What is the next one we had? Exception. Error message. In case if you are not entering the data, so we got error message. Is that was clear? Right, Amma? I hope you are good with this. We can give it, but here it will be very simple. We use a try catch only very rarely. So this, when you go to a custom exceptions, custom, we don't do all that nonsense in the Salesforce. Straight away, try catch at max, we'll be using it. Okay. So if you want to exhibit the entire OOPS oriented try catch, it's not necessary in this edge course. Okay. So let us make it very simple. Try catch. Here we don't have, we never write a try with multiple catches, try throw, throws. Okay. Custom exception. This is all Java dotted. In Salesforce, only try catch. As simple as it. Okay. There also, if you want to apply, not mandatory. As a part of good practices, we are trying to apply. It is not mandatory. Okay. I hope you are good with this. Right. Everyone has followed this one. So what is that page reference now? Page reference. Now, it is a predefined this class will refer to any one of the page. Now, syntax, how do you refer it? Page reference URL of page. Page reference URL. We can also give it like this. Page reference we can give URL. Suppose let us say I want to send the VF page as a attachment. Convert the VF page as a PDF, send as a email. Your invoice is there. Your invoice you are generating through your VF page. You are designing your own VF page for creating the invoice page. That invoice what is created, I want to send it to the customer as a email. Then we are going to use this page reference. Refer to the VF page by using page reference. Are you getting my point? Now you want to convert the VF page as a Word document, send as an email. You want to convert the VF page as a PDF, send as an email. Then we use page reference. The other example is, we can also refer like this. Page reference. Page reference. P equal to page dot. Now I can also give page name here. Page dot page name. Page dot page name. Now either I can give the URL or I can give the page dot page name. I hope you are good with this. VF page name. Visual Force page name. Visual Force page name.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. If you don't define the page reference, then when we call this will navigate back to same. Yes, Amma, go ahead. Online, go ahead.
See, yeah. Any insertion is success, where we want to navigate to the account is inserted, account details need to be displayed to the account page. If you suppose to navigate to other pages, like from account to contact,
ID should like know. That. ID, you have to know it. See, if I want to navigate to any page, to which page you want to navigate? See, if you want to navigate, you should know which page you want to navigate. To which record you have to navigate. Now, there are 1,000 records in the account. Now, in the 1,000 records, which record you want to navigate? Right? So, unless we know that, we cannot navigate. So, you have to tell to the system to which page you want to navigate. Okay, now? Got it? Yeah. I hope got your answer? Right. Right. Query is clarified, Amma. Okay. Now, look at this. This is my next trick format. Look at my next trick format. I have a pick list here. I have picklist here. When I select this as account, when I select this as account, I need to get account. List. This is how I have to get. If you select account, account data should come here. If I select contact, if I select contact, then what happened? This should be replaced with the contact data. If I select opportunity, if I select opportunity, then this should be replaced with the opportunity. Now, did you get my requirement? I am going to give a pick list where we have account, contact, and opportunity. If I select account, account form should come. When I select opportunity, opportunity form should come. When I select contact, contact form should come. If I select account form should come. If I select contact form should come. If I select opportunity form should come. Then when I click on the save the record, take me to the page. Save the record, take me to the page. I hope you got the requirement. Okay. Analyze the requirement. Try to build from your end. We'll discuss the point in a session. Okay. Now this is my requirement. Okay. Now let us move on to the next topic. Try from your end. Tomorrow I will discuss the requirement. Okay. Tomorrow I will discuss. But you try from your end what you can do it. Now I have a pick list here. Whichever the option I am selecting, I need to get a page block with that option. So that when I click on save, record should be saved to account. Record should be saved to contact. Record should be saved to opportunity. Now we get back to that particular record. In case any DML error comes, throw error message. In case if you are getting any DML errors, throw that error message. I hope everyone is good. Everyone is good with this. Requirement is clear. Whichever the option I am selecting, the concerned page block should come. When I click on save, the record should be saved to the particular table. Navigate back to the particular record. In case we are getting any error, you will get a print the error message. Try this example from your end. Okay. The next point here. Now come back to the story. The next point what I have is, boss, you are creating this example very good. How will somebody open this page? You are creating the VF pages. VF pages you are creating very good. Then what are you clicking? Clicking on a preview, you are seeing it. You are a developer, you are clicking on a preview. I am an end user. How will I open this page? You being a developer, writing a program, clicking on a preview, you are able to see. But my question is, I am not a developer. Then how will I open this page? How will I open this page? Okay, the possibilities. One of the possibilities is setup. Build, create, tabs, visual force, tabs, choose the page, choose the tab, like a custom object tab, we are choosing what? Visual Force page tab. Now we create a tab for the Visual Force. Next, say who can see this tab? Next, tell me in which application you want to add it. Tell me in which application you want to add it. Where was our sales? Created a tab. So go to the tab. We are getting here account contact. This is how we are able to open it. Are you getting my point? So being a developer, always you are clicking on a preview and watching it. But how would the end user will open this page? Because you are a developer, you are opening it. How would the end user open it? So we are supposed to create a tab for it. One of the choice. One of the choices, tab creation. One of the choices, tab creation. There are other choices like extensions, sidebar components. Okay, creating a buttons on the standard page. There are other choices. One of the choices is what? Creating a. Is that all clear for everyone? Now, I also give one quick extension here. Again.
Can we create this
VFH
tab in the custom app? VFH? VFH tab for custom.
Custom? Application. Anywhere you can add it. Is a tab? No. Tab can be added anywhere in the application. Is a tab. We can add any tab here. Okay. Now pick Visual Force pages into Lightning. Okay, now we are converting Visual Force page. Now the point is already we have lot of Visual Force pages. Now already we have lot of Visual Force pages. Now we create a Visual Force pages. Then the customer or the client told boss, I want the pages to be in the Lightning. Already you have created lot of Visual Force pages. Then what you are asking? Already you have done lot of Visual Force pages. Then you're asking, boss, I want to convert this Visual Force pages into Lightning because there are a lot of applications. Now I have written a lot of programming. When I have written a lot of programming, I cannot go and recreate all the Visual Force pages in the Lightning. Now I'm using this application from 10 years. Now if I want to migrate to Lightning, I cannot recreate every page in the Lightning. Am I right or wrong? Nobody will be interested to recreate the entire application in the Lightning. Boss, I have spent a lot of money and a lot of money I have spent in creating this Visual Force pages. Now, as a new technology came, new format came, I am happy to use that format. But what about my existing applications? What about my existing pages? There we have attribute called Lightning Sheets equal to. There's attribute called Lightning Sheets equal to. So what I am doing here? Go to the VF page. Here you'll be finding Lightning Sheets. I told Lightning Sheets equal to 2. Then I have a preview of this. Now, when you say Lightning Sheets equal to 2, basically this will give you look and feel of. This will give you look and feel of Lightning. Boss, in case you want to convert any one of the existing pages, if you want to convert any one of the existing pages with the look and feel of Lightning, we are supposed to give what? We are supposed to give Lightning Sheets equal to 2. Look at this. Now what happened is the same Visual Force page created in the form of the same VF page is opened in the Lightning with the Lightning view. I designed what? Visual Force page. But what are you getting here? Lightning view. It is not Lightning page. Lightning view. This is not Lightning development. This is Lightning view. Lightning view. Whatever the existing page was there, you want to open that in the Lightning. In the Lightning, only Lightning components will be opened. But this is the VF page. This is the VF page which I am opening. Now the VF page is getting opened in the Lightning because I told apply the Lightning style sheets. Now it is not converting the Visual Force page into Lightning. We are showing the same Visual Force page with the look and feel of Lightning. Now why we are going for this? Boss, if it is a new development, I will create everything in the Lightning very good. But there is an application which I built from last 10 years with hundreds of programs, hundreds of pages. Now I cannot re-spend the money in converting everything into Lightning. Then in that case, what I can do? If the Visual Force pages open in the Lightning, it is enough for me. If the Visual Force pages open in the Lightning, If the look and feel of lightning, it's enough. I don't want the lightning architecture to be applied. I don't want lightning architecture to be applied. I just want to say look and feel of the VFA should be like lightning, and there should be open in the lightning. Even though it is a visual force space, I want that visual force space to be open in the lightning. That's why I told simply lightning style should equal to. Why did we discuss this point? Because I created a tab for a VF page. Now the tab, if you want to open from lightning application, how will it open? Right? So I should have, when I create a tab, I want the tab to be used in the lightning as well as in the classic. So there's a reason why we just created a point, why we want to use this particular point. So if you want to, if you are migrating from classic to lightning, if you are migrating from classic to lightning, it is not necessary that you have to rebuild everything which is existing. We can get the structure in the look and feel of lightning, and new functionalities, whatever you are trying to build, build those in lightning. I hope you are good. Clear for everyone? Right? Concepts are clear. So we have seen page messages, try catch, pay, okay, page reference. I hope everyone is good with the topics. Clear? Am I clear with this? Clear for everyone? That's all from my end for today. Yes, Amma. We can do it, Amma, but we don't require it. In the down the line, I'll be covering it. So, we don't want to hit all the bunch as a time.